A man who helped define the Memphis sound in the 60s is now giving a new generation of artists a big chance to do the same thing. Legendary producer and songwriter David Porter opened his new recording studio this week in Memphis, and the name says it all. It's called Made in Memphis.
And this morning, we are taking you live inside the new multi-million dollar studio to see just how the magic happens. And the man himself, Mr. David Porter, joins us live this morning. Oh, there he is. Good morning, David. Break it down for us. What is Made in Memphis Entertainment all about?
Made in Memphis Entertainment is all about Memphis. It's all about the uniqueness that makes the signature sound of Memphis respected all over the world, Alex. It's about the new energy of young people and talented young people that people have wondered if that kind of talent was still in the city. It's all about, it's in the city right now. It's happening right now, and you're going to be hearing it very, very soon.
That is so cool. So it's going to further Memphis's reputation. It's going to give a chance to new artists to show their stuff. You already have some artists signed, in fact.
Matter of fact, we do, Mary Beth. You should have been here the other day. We had Alex, who was so busy dancing, I couldn't figure out those moves he was doing. I said, what is going on?
I wish you'd gotten that on tape.
No, you don't want to see that.
One thing was clear. The vibe was correct. He was down for it. He was down.
Love
we
it.
Missed having you. But yeah, no, we've got so much to introduce to the world that's coming out of Memphis, Mary Beth. We've already recorded two albums on the launch artist for the label, a young lady by the name of Porcelain, who I understand you guys will speak to in a little bit, and Matthew Michael, who is a tremendously talented young man as well. So we've got two major projects that we're going to launch the label with, and we're very, very excited.
David, a lot of people will be interested to find out, is this traditional, what we consider Memphis music, maybe kind of a throwback to soul and R&B from, you know, 30, 40, 50 years ago, or is this totally something different?
I love that question, Alex, because, you know, if we were going to try to redo Soul Man, I'd be very upset because I want to get all of the royalties that were back in the 60s off of Soul Man. I don't want a duplication of that. But no, this is about the current. This is about the current credibility of world-appealing music out of Memphis today. When you consider the fact that so many of the young talents that are from Memphis are with, for instance, Bruno Mars has a Memphis compliment in his band. So mm-hmm. does Maxwell. So does Justin, and Justin is a part of this area. So we've got already the credibility of what's here. Now we're making it homegrown and staying here. So these are young talents that are still here, and they got all the juice that anyone else can imagine that they would see in a Bruno Mars or an Adele or Justin or whoever. And that's the thing that makes this so exciting. That's why we wanted to give the proper name to it. Made in Memphis Entertainment.
The name is
real.
The name is perfect, and this is just a continuum of what you've done for years with your consortium, where you support new artists, you network with them, you connect them with industry experts like yourself. So it's so cool. Thank you, David. We will be back with you. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Well, I was going to say that we're trying to be sure that all of that perpetuates the credibility of our city.
All right, David Porter, you're doing just that. And a little bit later on, we're going to get a chance to hang out with one of your artists, Porcelain. She's coming up later, and she is incredible.
Phenomenal. Thanks, David.
David Porter, thank you.